Good morning, student. Now I am going to solve the NCERT example. And question is, determine equivalent resistance of the network and current along each edge of the cube consisting of 12 resistors. Each of resistance is 1 ohm. So circuit diagram is given in the NCERT book. And a student see here. Battery which is 10 volt and they will supply a current of total current that is what? 3i. And resistance of each resistor that is what? 1 ohm. So here 3i ohm comes to a point A and junction law takes place. Resistance of each arm that is what? 1. So equal current is divided. So 3i comes to here. So here I. Again at a point B. Again, resistance of these two arms that is what? Same. So, equal current is what? Divided here. Here I by 2. So, again here current comes out to be I. Here I by 2 and here I by 2. Here comes to I. Again I by 2 and I by 2. And this I by 2 and this I by 2 becomes I. This I by 2 and this I by 2 becomes I. And here I by 2 here C and I by 2 come to at C. So again there will be what? I. So total current entering to the circuit 3I and you see that I plus I that is what? 3I. So total current entering into the circuit which is equal to total current leaving the circuit. And this circuit is already given. Only you have to find the total resistance of this cubical circuit. And student apply Kirchhoff law. Here apply Kirchhoff law to A, B, C, C dash and here that is what? E and again A. And student apply Kirchhoff loop law to A, B, C, C dash and then come back to E and A. Apply Kirchhoff's loop law to loop A, B, C, C dash, E, A. Here that is what? Current flowing, resistance that is what? 1. Direction of the current and direction of the traverser that is what? Same. So product of I and R that is what? Positive. Direction of the traverser is also from A, B, C, C dash E A and direction of the current is also in the same direction. So product of current and resistance that is what? Positive. And here resistance that is what? 1 ohm. So here A to B current I resistance that is what? 1 plus current I to resistance 1 ohm. So I by 2 into current that is what? 1. Here current I resistance 1 ohm. So that is what? I into resistance 1 ohm. And student, now see you are taking the path A, B, C, C dash, E, A. And you are moving this path. And in case of cell, you move from negative terminal of the cell to positive terminal of cell. So it is taken to be what? Positive. So it is what? 10. Solving this. II 2i, 2i plus I by 2 equal to what? 10. And student 5i that is what? 5i by 2 that is what? 10. So 5i equal to what? 20. So I equal to what? 20 by. So I equal to 4 ampere. So current flowing into the circuit that is what? 3 ampere total current. But here we find that is I. So total current through the circuit that is what? Total current 3i which is equal to what? 3 into 4 and that is what? 12 ampere. Now we find the total resistance of the cubical circuit. So total resistance that is R equivalent equal to what? potential difference PD by total current and total current, that is what potential difference, that is what 10 volt, and total current student, that is what 3i, not I. So this comes out to by what 12, and solving this comes out to by what 5 by 6 ohm. So equivalent resistance, that is, comes out to be that 5 by 6 ohm, and total current that is what 12 ampere. And student, in this question you have to find current in each branch. Here branch AB, that is what I, so total current, that is what 4 ampere. Here BC, I by 2, it means what 2 ampere. Here I also, that will be what 4 ampere. So you have already find out the value of I, so you can easily write the current across each edge, that is what AB, BC, CC dash, and each arm you can easily write down the current flowing through the edges of the cubical block. And total resistance 5 by 6 ohm, and total current, that is what 12 ampere. Now student, next question is, in the given circuit find the current I1, I2, I3. So we have to find current I1, I2 and I3, and circuit is already given here. So student, in this circuit first we apply the Kirchhoff loop law. So we have to find current I1, I2, I3. So first we apply the loop law to A, B, G, H, A. We have chosen the path A, B, G, H, A, and in the direction of the chosen path and the direction of the current is also in the same direction. So product of current and resistance, that is what positive. So apply Kirchhoff loop law to B, G, H, A. So here current and resistance, that is what positive, their product is what positive. Only one resistance and current is there, and two cell is there, and we are moving from negative terminal to positive terminal. So here EMF, that is what potential difference, that is what positive. So here positive, and when we are moving from here positive to negative, so here potential difference, that is what negative. So that is what -2 + 2 - 2, that is what 0. 5 I1 = 0, so current I1, that is what 0. In the same way student, now we apply the Kirchhoff loop law to B, C, F, G, B. This is the path B, C, F, G, B, and here apply Kirchhoff loop law to C, C, F, G, B, C, C, F, G, B, C, F, B, C, F, G, B, C. And student, see here, path of charge in the same direction of the current. So product of resistance and current, that is what positive. Now here direction of the traverser is just opposite to the direction of the current. So here we are moving from G to B, and direction of the current from B to G. So here product of current and resistance, that is what negative. So here 5 by 2 - 5 I1, and in case of cell we are moving from negative to positive terminal, it will be what, this is the +2 volt, and when we are moving from positive to negative, so it comes out to be the -2 volt. So +2 - 2, that is what 0. So 5 I2 - 5 I1, that is what 0, and 5 I2 and I1, that is what already calculated, that is what 0. So 5 I2, that is what 0, so I2 will also be what 0. So current I1 0, current I2 0. Now again we apply the same Kirchhoff loop law to D E F C D. Again we apply the Kirchhoff loop law to circuit D E F C D, and direction of the path traverser and the direction of the product of current and resistance here also be taken, that is what? Positive. So 5 by 3, that is what? Positive. But we are moving from F to C, current is what? C to F. So here product of current and resistance is what? Negative. So that is what? 5 by 3 minus 5 by 2. And in the same way, we are moving from negative terminal to positive terminal of the cell. So potential difference, this is what? +2. And moving from C to D, positive terminal to negative terminal, so it is taken to be what? -2. So +2 -2, that is what? 0. So student, 5 by 3 minus 5 I2, and I2 already calculated, that is what? 0. So 5 into 0, which is equal to 0. So 5 I3 equal to what? 0. And so we find that I3 will also be 0. So student, you see there will be current I1, I2 and I3 in this circuit, that is what? 0. Next question, circuit shows here. Student, in this circuit, galvanometer G shows no zero deflection. Find the value of resistance R. In this circuit, galvanometer shows no deflection, and we have to find the value of resistance R. So student, if galvanometer shows no deflection, it means what? No current is passed through this loop. So this circuit can be changed in another form, and this galvanometer can be removed, and this circuit can be written in this manner. And suppose that student, current I is start flowing from here, and this current is flowing, and there will be no current flowing through this arm, so this current comes out to here. So that will be what? I, and this will be what? I current entering into the circuit and leaving the circuit. Total current leaving the circuit, total current into, that is what? I. Here no current is passed through there, and we have to find R. Now student, first we apply, here we given name A, B, C, D, E, F. First we apply Kirchhoff's loop law to A, B, C, D, E, F, A. Apply Kirchhoff's loop law to A, B, C, D, E, F, A. See here, student. Here, direction of the traversal and the direction of the current, that is what? Same. So product of resistance and current, that is what? Positive. 500 I. And no other resistance and current here. And here, we are moving from positive terminal to negative terminal of the cell. So it is taken to be what? Negative. And here comes to that, we move from negative to positive terminal, it is taken to be what? Positive. So it comes out to be that 10. So we can write here 500 I equal to what? 10. So I equal to what? By removing this, so I comes out to be that 1 by 50 ampere. Now student, apply loop law to A, B, E, F, A. Apply Kirchhoff's loop law to A, B, E, F, A. Here direction of the traversal, so product of resistance and current, that is what? Positive. 500 I. Here current is passing, that is IR. Also that is what? Positive. Direction of the current and direction of the traversal, that is what? Same. So product of IR are positive, and we are moving from negative terminal to positive terminal, so it is written as what? 12. And student, we know that current I already calculated 1 by 50. So here put the value of current 1 by 50. And here that is what? 1 by 50 into R. And that is what? 12. And this cancel out, and it comes out to be that 10. So student, here 10 plus R by 50 equal to 12. It comes out to be that R by 50 equal to 12 minus 10. So R comes out to be that is what, 2. So R comes out to be 100 ohm. And this is the answer of the resistance R equal to 100 ohm. Next question is, given circuit here, but no distribution of current is here. And in this circuit, we have to find potential difference across each cell, E1 and E2, and the rate of energy dissipation in R, that is here. And this R is given, that is what, 4 ohm. So student, no current distribution is here. So here positive terminal of the cell and here also positive terminal of the cell. So we can assume current, cell E1 send a current I1 into the circuit and cell E2 send a current I2 into the circuit. And I1 comes out to here and I2 comes out to here, and Johnson law takes place in this resistance R, current flowing, that is what, I1 plus I2, and the circuit is completed. Now again, here current in this arm, that is what, I1, and again in this arm, that is what, I2. So distribution of current is completed. Now student, now I am going to apply Kirchhoff loop law to two loop. First loop B A D C B, apply Kirchhoff loop, and again A D E F A, and solve this, we find the value of I1 and I2. So students, see here, apply Kirchhoff loop law to BADCB, BADCB, direction of the traverser and direction of the current is also in the same direction. So product of current and resistance, that is what, positive, current and resistance positive, and cell, that is what, negative to positive, so negative terminal to positive, so it is positive. So here 4 I1 plus I2 positive plus 2 I1 positive equal to cell negative to positive 12. So 4 I1 and 2 I1, 6 Y1 and 4 I2, which is equal to 12, divided by 2, 3 I1 plus 2 I2 equal to 6. This is equation 1. Again, students, see, apply Kirchhoff loop law to ADEFA. ADEFA. Direction of the path choice and the direction of the current is also same. So product of current and resistance positive, current and resistance positive. So here 4 I1 plus I2, that is what? I1 plus R2 multiplied by 4, current and resistance, plus resistance and current. Current resistance 1, current, that is what, I2. And we are moving from what? Negative terminal to positive terminal. So potential difference, that is what? Positive. And 4I1, as it is, 4I2 plus I2, that is what, 5I2, which is equal to 6. Now here 2I2, here 5I2. Now multiply equation 1 by 5 and equation 2 by 2 by eliminating I2. So equation 1 multiplied by 5, it comes out to be that what, 15I1 plus 10I2, 30. And equation 2 multiplied by 2, that is what, 8I1 plus 10I2 equal to 12, minus, subtracted, 10I2, 10I2 cancelled, 15 minus 8, 7I1, and 30 minus 12, that is what, 18. So I1 comes out to be that 18 by 7 ampere. So current I1, that is what, 18 by 7, and value of I1 put into the equation 1. So here equation 1 can be written as 3 into I1, that is 18 by 7, plus 2I2 equal to 6. And solving this, student, I2 comes out to be that minus 6 by 7 ampere. And student, see here that potential difference across AD, potential difference across R means what? Potential difference across R, which is equal to what? Potential difference across the cell E1 as well as cell E2. So first of all, we find the potential difference across 4 ohm, and you know that resistance and current product, that is what? Potential difference. So potential difference across AD, which is equal to the potential difference across each cell. So a student, here we write potential difference across each cell, which is equal to potential difference across R. And potential difference across R means what? Potential difference and current. So that is what? Current flowing in this arm, that is what? I1 plus I2, and resistance, that is what? R. I1 and I2 calculated. I1, that is what? 18 by 7, and I2, that is what? Minus 6 by 7. So denominator is set, same. 18 minus 6, that is what? 12. 12 into 4, 48 by 7. So potential difference across each cell comes out to be that 48 by 7 volt. Potential difference across each cell, which is equal to the potential difference across 4 ohm resistors. Now we have to find the, now we have to, energy dissipation in resistance R, and you know that energy dissipation in R, we use formula P equal to what? I E square R. And student, that is what? I here, that is what? I1 plus I2. So here that is what? I1 plus I2 whole square into resistance, that is what? 4. And student, I1 plus I2 already calculated, which is comes out to be that what? 12 by 7. So here 12 by 7 comes out to be that is what? Square into, that is what? 4. And it comes out to be that 144 by 49 into 4. And solving this, 4 4 16 4 4 16 7 576 by 49, and its answer comes out to be that 11.75 joule. This is the rate of energy dissipated. So here rate of energy dissipated means what? E by rate of energy dissipated, and which comes out to be that 11.75 joule. Thank you.